this one either. This is the one. Yes. This is a box of small items. This is an Intel Pentium processor. I understand. These pins are made of gold. This is a mechanism for a music box. Or now that I think about it, it's for the mobile that hung above one of our cribs. That brings back memory. Here's a Louisville and Nashville railroad button. A magic box. going to make this time disappear. What do you think about that? This is a Frito Bandito pencil topper from the late 1960s. Let's see how it looks on this pencil. Here is another pencil topper. This one is W.C. Fritos. Also from the late 1960s. Or maybe the early 1970s. These two pencil toppers came in packages of Frito corn chips. Let me continue to amaze you with my lame, childish magic tricks. Three nine. Trinkets wonder, this bug is alive after all these decades. Commemorative pin, New York City Fire Department. And here's a monkey. And here's a presidential campaign button. And here's a Super Bowl ring. If I can light this pencil. and that looks like a penny. And invested this penny back when it was made today, it would be worth 11 cents. Enough of that silliness. This is a toy. Derringer. It's a cap gun. Put the caps right there. Here is an Atlanta Braves souvenir World Series pin, 1995. I attended some of those games. What else do we have? Some kind of creepy alien ball. And here is another World Series souvenir pin. Here's a little bracelet. One of my kids used to wear. This is a little trick that will allow you to guess the picture from a card that somebody chooses. I think this came in a box of cereal 20 or 25, 30 years ago. Maybe it's not quite as old as I think. And here's another walnut shell without the bug inhabiting it. What about this one? Yep. And there she is. Now, here is a mighty sweet motorcycle. I believe it's made by Mattel Hot Wheels. Another railroad button, Amtrak. I don't recall where I got this, but this appears to be a 1922 Liberty Heads over Dollar. I'm not sure if it's real. I should test it. Perhaps one day I will test it to see if it's real or not. Here's a little flashlight that seems to be attached. Magnetic, or I should say, the contents of the container are magnetic. Much like a Jedi Knight, the Force is strong. American flag, lapel pin. Am I self-centered, or is it just me? Da Vinci Award. destination, imagination. Postage stamp pin. I could probably saw this box with this pin. Every child is born an artist. The problem is how to remain an artist once he is grown up. Pablo Picasso. Here's another destination, imagination pin. A bush, Dan Quayle campaign button. It's from 1988. This monkey looks like it goes with the other. I'll put them over here. They can become best friends. Now best one yet. And that's creepy. And would you believe it? An Atlanta Braves souvenir pin. Back to back world champions. And yet another I'm not sure where I got this. Opryland. Tennessee. This is a flattened out penny. It's a souvenir. I should put a battery in this. Give it to my wife so she can put it in her purse. Here's the little kitten. It's a symbol of the chassis system. My son had an engineer's cap, and all of these railroad buttons he had attached to the cap. There's an angel. Here's another flattened penny. This is what an SD40-2 can do to a penny if you lay it on the railroad track. Here's a token for a golf driving range. Napa 500 NASCAR race. And another button. If I agreed with you, we'd both be wrong. Here's the gateway to the west, the arch in St. Louis. There's Jefferson, I believe. Quite the view from the top of the arch. And here's the old spider in the ice cube gag. And here's a money clip with turquoise. I have no idea where that came from. Here's another button with a guitar pick lodged in it. tender, thin. It looks like my dog might have chewed on it. There's another railroad pin. Have I showed you any of my Atlanta Braves souvenir pins? Sorry, I had to take a drink. Another American flag. Here's an award for academic excellence. And another souvenir from some amusement park somewhere. And yet another. Torino, 1970. Torino. And here's an angel. Love. We should always love one another. I have no idea where that one came from. Evidence photographer, International Council. I once dabbled with forensics. The Kennedy half dollar. It's worth 50 cents. And here's another money clip. Norfolk, Southern. It's another railroad button. Another souvenir pin. Knights of Columbus pin. Chuck E. Cheese token. Where a kid can be a kid. It's a baseball key fob. I used to coach kids baseball. Have I showed you any of my Atlanta Braves souvenir pins? Oh, brother. There's Jim Carrey as the Riddler. I guess that's from a Batman movie. I don't know, 20 years ago. Silly souvenir penny. The best way to remember trips to amusement parks is with photographs. Hey, it fits. Here's a little fish. I guess this one on a charm bracelet, or perhaps a necklace. Here's another angel. It's a little Cub Scout pin. I think that's Garfield the cat. And here's a nickel. And it's worth a nickel. Seaboard system. B&O, Baltimore and Ohio Railroad. And another flattened out penny. Thanks to the railroad. Another New York City Fire Department commemorative pin. Another pin. And last but not least, another monkey. And everybody knows what these monkeys are all about. Hear no evil. See no evil. Speak no evil. I wished it was that simple. W.C. Frito wants to have a word with these monkeys. He's asking if they've seen the Riddler. No, I'm not high. Thanks for watching.